One, two, three.
Reason stuntmen can go do dangerous stunts, and we think, oh wow, that's amazing. They've actually thought it through beforehand, and they've looked at all the things that can go wrong. And that's actually what we call risks, things that can go wrong that can harm us or cause damage to something. They've looked at all that and looked at ways and how they can reduce that chance of that happening. So even though what they're doing looks dangerous, they've actually managed a lot of risks. So they reduce the chance of something bad happening. What we're going to do today is we're going to look at how to think through something and manage the risks. It's a good skill to have in a job. If you're a person who can go to a job site and not injure yourself or someone else, you're going to be a good employee. Today we're going to look at campfires. Something you want to be able to do around the outdoor classroom here. So, we're going to look at two words. So we've got hazard and a risk. Anyone have a guess at what's the difference?
Nothing.
Now, adults didn't even notice.
Nothing.
Nothing? Anyone want to have a guess?
Yeah.
Very, very good, very close. So a hazard is an object or a situation that can lead to something bad happening. Example, a campfire, even though a campfire is good, it can be a steep side of a hill could be a hazard. The risk, so now we've said what a hazard is, have a guess at what risk might be.
The way
it
spreads.
Sorry?
Spreads.
Oh, so a fire spreading. Alright, excellent. So that's an example of a risk. The risk is the bad thing we don't want to happen. That's what a risk is. So the hazard is the object or situation, the risk is the bad thing. Alright, so just quickly looking at a campfire, what are some of the bad things that could happen? Just
pick everything.
No, just pick one thing. Yeah. Alright, bushfire. That's an obvious one. Put that number one, bushfire. What's another thing that bad that could happen? And that's what you're talking about, spreading. Yeah? What's another bad thing? Yeah? Burns. That's a big one. Yeah? Let's do one more. Think of what we do around a campfire here every day, Nelly. Yeah? What do I have every day? Tea. What could be a risk with this type of tea?
Spilling it. Hot water.
Scalds. That's probably the biggest danger. The biggest. All of them separate. Alrighty.
You do you.
And we could keep going with some more risks. Alright. Now, this is the important part. We've listed the risks. Right? So what we need to do is think about what are the things that could happen, what are the factors that could lead to these bad things happening. As it is the fire, what are the factors that could lead to a bushfire, a burn, or a squall? People factors, environment factors, equipment. So think about people around your campfire. What is stuff that people might do or not do to cause burn, to cause a bushfire?
The paper box.
Yep.
The paper box.
What about paper box? Alright, so moving, moving things out of the fire or something?
Yeah.
Or making the fire too big.
Alright, so making fire too big or playing with it, is that what you're saying? Playing with it, where they put sticks or paper bags
and sticks out
around you. Think of you having a little campfire. What would you be worried about if you've got five people around?
People playing around, messing around.
Being, just being stupid, yeah.
Horseplay.
Oh, that's a good one. Mm-hmm. Not enough room for horseplay, but that's good. Alright, moving on from people. What about the environment around your campfire? What are some factors that could lead to a bushfire happening?
Sticks and leaves and stuff like
laying
around
next
to the fire.
Too close to fire, so we're done.
I almost made that mistake at my house. I almost burnt my own house down the other day.
Alright, by having stuff too close to fire?
Yeah, I had the wheelbarrow too close and it was full of wood and stuff.
Alright.
I picked it up and moved it was boiling hot.
Alright.
I was like, oh gosh, if I didn't move that soon, you know,
fire. Yeah, it can happen really quick. So that's an environmental factor, dry leaves too close. What else to do with the environment that could affect your little campfire and lead it into going into a bushfire? What about the temperature? What about the dryness? What about wind?
Wind.
I need to start keeping an eye on that before I get
Yeah, because lately there's been like some days it's like fire.
Yeah.
When do they normally put fire bans on?
When it's windy and dry.
And because they've got a risk management plan like this, it says when it gets to a certain temperature and wind, they just say, right, no one's to have a fire.
Yes.
Alright, last one, equipment. What things could impact or affect whether you have a bushfire or not? Squeeze something to put it out. We have a fire blanket hanging up there,
which is probably 100 years old.
It will actually pull it out and smut. Well, how do you think a fire blanket would work?
You pull it out.
Why does it work? Why does it go out there?
Oxygen.
Why is it oxygen? Yep. Alright, so put it. Maybe having access to water. Alright. Now we could go on. We're not going to do it now. We go on with burns, what can cause burns, and we think through what are the people factors that can cause burns. What's the environmental factors? An example might be having uneven ground. Just the fact that if you light a fire on uneven ground, the more chance of people tripping and falling onto the fire. Equipment, just quickly, without writing it up, what could affect or increase the chance of someone getting a scald or burned in relation to equipment?
Having stuff laying around next to the fire,
you can trip on it. Yep, having a messy campsite. Yep. What about our billies and saucepans and stuff? I saw it happen the other day at one of our billies. Someone picked up the billy, didn't have any hot water in it, and the handle come off. So maybe the condition of your cooking equipment. Because you picked up something, you imagine carrying boiling water and the handle falls off. Is that boiling water going everywhere? So the condition of equipment. So in summary, to do a risk management plan, you look at the hazard that you want to deal with. In our case, a campfire, we want to manage a campfire. You think of all the bad things that can happen. It's quite a depressing job to do. You think of all the things that you don't want to happen. You list them out. Then you think of the things that could lead to it happening. In the next lesson, we're going to look at how do we use this information to reduce the risk. So when you have a campfire, you've already thought about wind. You've already thought about whether it should be cleared. You've already thought about the equipment. Is that handle on the saucepan strong enough? you've already thought about, if you're managing the fire, to get five kids around it, what are you going to do if that starts snuffing up? What are you going to do if that's rolling light on the fire? All this sort of stuff. See, that's what you've got to think about. You, by doing this, you would have already thought about how you're going to deal with it. So that's the lesson for today. Thank you.